and welcome to Keith's Workshop. We had a little trouble, so we had to start over again. I'll see what the clock is. But last time we built we was working on this one, and we made these. This is kind of the frame where the towers are standing on, and we make the slide here. That's the ammo, a kind of being hurled up. This time we will start to build the towers, and the towers is this one where the pivot point of the kind of catapult or trebuchet, as we call this one. And first I have made the measurement on this, and they are what did I get it to? 19, or that's 190 millimeters this way, and kind of 29 from bottom to top to the pointy bit. And I draw this on a piece of cardboard like I did last one. With the last one, it's easier for you to follow what I'm doing, and then it's easier to make. So I have to move this one, because now I'm out of room for my stick. Move it over here a little bit. And see, I have to cut it in angles. And I have cut this just a minute ago before I figured out we forgot to record. As we know, record, you don't have anything to look up and look on. And you can, of course, find everything I make. You can find on pixelfantasy.com, and Pixelfantasies, that's what you see down in the corner of the left corner of your screen. And if you go to my site here, you can see I have put this part up, so you can see what it made up, the frame and the slide, as I showed you before. You can see what's its the measurements on it and how to do it. So it's when you are sitting and making it. So standing and making it rather, but the measurement between the sticks between the frame kind of, and the slide here, and the end, and how the slide are made, and it always depending on what tools you can get around where you are, or not what tools you can get, but kind of sticks you can get. They of course don't have to be exact same dimensions as I use, but this is what I could get. If they are a little thicker or a little thinner, that don't matter. Hey, so don't do that. See, I make a mark down here on the stick. Go to stick down to the bottom there. I make a mark down here where stickies, and then I make a mark here on the top where it has to end. So, and then I do my trusted angle. So, and then I do over this side, where the other one is. And be pretty precise. Then you don't have to grind like you sandpaper for days afterwards. And then you kind of make a mark up here so you can see where. And those on the side are very important when you're sawing, so you can see that you are doing it right. Okay, are they? Yes, the sound right. Okay. Just to check. Better catch the errors now than later. Here you're gonna cut. I will do like this. I did that before. I will do that again. And you can better see. Here. Do that too. We have sound on and everything. Yes. See, now we have a problem with the it's kind of a top angle too. It's not easy to handle. How do we do that, my dear lady? We need the so you cannot see anything, can you? When we will do like this, now you can see. So it's a little difficult to get room for the saw blade and in this particular angle. And the hands and whatnot. See, and this time it's the other side of the stroke, on the right side of the stroke you are sawing, and then the nail down to the where it fits, so the nail touches the wood and then you can slide the blade of the saw up against the nail. Then you have kind of a little handle on it, so you can steer it kind of. And as I told before our troubles, that you need to, or not you need to, it's a little harder to saw this along the grain than it is perpendicular to the grains, because it's kind of softer this way. And the blade are not gripping that good, but let the saw work, and you will get there. And follow the stroke down the side so that you are sure that the angle of the cut is right. This is stroke that way down, and the same over here, because the loose material away so you can see the stroke. You have to get a kind of veneer or something, glue a piece of sandpaper on so you can, because this got a lid. I'm going to straighten it up a little. But you can see kind of my butt. Where is my I took but you can see it's kind of close. There are no room between. So, and we can of course lay it down and see if it works. And then I get a little too busy to on the, but we can do that here. If this is long enough, it is. One has to be lucky once in a while. Take this away here first. See how that fits. Mega. Kind of. This was the one. And as you see on the on the finished one, if yours are not then we are putting a plate over here at last anyway, so but try to get it as fine as possible. But then we put a one of these flat. Too much stuff, one of these where we have glued two of these together in my case, but maybe not you, so that we kind of have a kind of a little plate over there to strengthen it all up. just a second. I need to have a pot of coffee. I'm talking like I don't know what. But that was this. We will so we can mark the last. I'm not that impressed with these clamps, I have to say. to ensure. This time. Yes, and from the other side. I could, of course, do this easy on the machine, but I'm not cheating. Do it the same way that you would. Why are this? So, see where it is. Jump. And then you try again. Measure twice, cut once. This is a little easy because it's kind of the other way on the grains, so there's something wrong with this thing. I need to take it apart. Follow the line so you get straight down. So, see, that was much easier. Much, much, much easier. So, best we cut that too. Let's see if that fits anywhere. It does. And we lock it. And which was one was it? Was this one? Kind of bush. And what is this? I don't remember, we have made three of them, but does it fit anything? Not too good, but we will take one more stick. Is there anyone? Oh, it's one of those that are thin in one end and thick in another. It's first down here, is it? What can we see? It's only 8. It's okay to be 8, but then it has, oh, this don't fit anything. It's kind of have to come from the same batch. This is the same size. Yes. And you can see the same size, and the, always the grain are the same way, then it's often the same size. So, just as you know. And then, just take it kind of up to the corner or the so. Move. And so, oh, sorry, there was a camera there. And we will see if that fits anything. Kind of don't. side so I can see. Is my ankle crooked or something? The reason I have tape on is that to prevent it from drawing on the or mess the, what I think there's something wrong. Sorry. Then it is me. How the... Do not understand. That I have not figured out yet why I keep making them. Is it because I think it's because the angle I see it. Yes. Sorry for that. It don't matter how many times I tell people what I'm doing, and then they don't understand. Difficult. so. And then and go a long way around. Normally you shouldn't stand with it in the air like I do. That's because I want you to see what I'm doing. Just so you know, what was this? We take one more. Yes, that's right. Okay, just checking. From here to the corner. So now we hit the corner. Is there room for me? Yes. So otherwise I never get through. Because work. Not quite. I'm not at all tempted to use the machine. No, no. Time. This all fall on the floor. So next time we sit us down there, so you don't have to See if it's kind of fits. It kind of does. Never get it 100% when you're hand sewing it like I do here. So but it's good enough. And then we have two of those glued together, but put that in here again. But what was it? I should have I don't remember. Let's see what we have here. There are one up there. Or are there two? There are one up there in the middle. How high up are they? Or should we? We have these two towers here. And then we have over here, and then we have here. Maybe we should make this first, because then we have a little more hole on it when we put them on. And then we have to make the one in the middle so that we have a little more strength in it when we start to glue it together, so it don't stand and jump around, because it's difficult to kind of keep holding it. So when the angle is like that, so let's make, so we have two of those. We will do that. This is just a cut. So that's not that important. Just so we can make two of. But where do we have our? We have our cutting box. Now we can use our cut box, because we are. Yeah. Can you see anything there? Yes. Not as much to see, but you can. Maybe we should do it like this. That was maybe a little smaller. It's not good with this. I think we need a repair there or something. Grip in it. And then take this one. Just have to glue these two together so that we can. So take a cotton stick. And how do they like this? Some small ones. Okay. This could do it. Just one of these days, those days. Stop it! Please. Thank you. this on here. Nope. I have some cover. Kind of one of these days. What's the clock? I think we will make this dry and then we will stop for today. And remember, it's every evening from now on and the same time as today, 6 p.m. my time, plus what is it? I think it's plus 1 UTC, but it's yeah. But we will finish this the next time, and then I would hope I don't have all the problems I have this time with the computer and this and that and everything. So I will say thank you, and I will put this up so you can see it, and then I will see you tomorrow.